Okie dokie. Let's see, what do I want to play? I was kind of digging Control Paladin the other day. Might try and run that back. I don't know if I need this Ysera really. I'm gonna just drop Ysera completely for something more into aggro. I'm gonna throw two hammers in there. I'ma hammer some stuff, man. What up, Stones? What up, TSPLO Day? What up, Devastation with some numbers? How's it going, guys? Maybe I'll hit Legend today, you know? Maybe we'll make it. I guess I keep Eldor. I don't mind it. He mulligans all three, huh? All three. Good day, everybody. Good day, dude. It's going great today, man. It's Friday. After this, the weekend. Gotta do tournaments this weekend. Try and get some BlizzCon points. It's my little brother's birthday. I celebrate that.
I was gonna put an
offer in on a house, and I was all excited about that. But the problem with it was, I don't want to use the coin here, so I want to use the two manifest cards. I could potentially have just like Aldered there or played Acolyte. But I want to save the coin so I can try and get one of these sixes out earlier. But I went through the meeting to put in my offer, had my checkbook out, was ready to go and everything. And then I just remembered, wait a minute, let me call the internet company and make sure the internet here is good enough to stream. And it was in an area that was like downtown, so I assumed, yeah, it'll probably be good enough to stream, but I just want to double check to make sure. And nope. The internet was not good enough to stream at the place I was looking at, so I guess I'm going to have to start my search all over again. So, rip dreams. Alright. I guess we're getting this accolade out here. We don't get much else we can do. No quality combo yet. Kind of stuff. Could have a quality this turn to try and like coin Avenging Wrath, but using the quality to deal 3 damage kind of blows. I'm gonna just try and. There we go. We can do that. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. No heal on our hand turn. I think it's okay to just Pyromancer quality and then try and do Owl or Avenging Wrath next turn. I mean, Sylvanas or Avenging Wrath. Any of the tournaments being streamed? No, I'm playing like really small tournaments and I'm trying to set up with a viewer here. You guys may have seen him here. Elefino has been here in the channel a few times. He runs an open tournament, and I'm trying to get him to cast it with me on my channel. So he may be casting his open tournament on this channel this weekend. Should be pretty cool. I don't usually cast too much, but I've been looking to try and do it as much as possible. And whenever I can help out a viewer, help out the open tournament scene, try and help the community, I want to take that opportunity. So he's been doing it for like a while now, and hasn't been getting that much viewership on like YouTube and stuff, but hopefully I can help him out and try and make the tournament scene get some light. Alright. Give me a good minion. Oh wait, it's not gonna kill anything. Fire it up. Kirby just subscribed. Thanks for subscribing, Kirby. Look at the Batcave team thing, man. Deck Doctor is not happening today, but come back Tuesday. Got some Deck Doctor action, man. Alright, how am I doing this? I think I would prefer most the Knife Juggler. So I can just go here to try and take it. I can try and just clear the board this turn and not take anything. And just leave Sylvanas as an annoying 5-2. I think that might be better. So I think I want to like consecrate Coin Hammer. I really want to just Tyrion on him though. I could go here and then try and Tyrion on him. Alright, I'm gonna see what it takes first and then make up my mind. It doesn't take anything too useful. So, is it still worth it? I could Belcher Owl. Could Avenging Rat, could Consecrate. I'm gonna just Belcher Owl. This at least baits his Owl too, so the Tyrion's not gonna be getting Owled if he does have the Owl. I don't really want Tyrion getting Owled. Oh jeez, nah, he's extending a lot to the Consecrate though. Oh my god, man, the jug is so big. Taking damage. I'm just gonna hammer Consecrate, so let's get this hammer out of the way. Try and get closer to some heals and stuff. Hopefully he doesn't have too strong of a turn and we can just plop down Tyrion and call it a game. What's this Pally deck? This is the control Pally deck that I was deck doctoring the other day. So I thought it was fun, so I'm still playing it. Alright, I'm gonna get Tyrion down this turn. So although the Geddon value is delicious, I'm gonna try and force this Tyrion out using this Wild Pyromancer. I have this equality combo, so I don't really need the Wild Pyromancer equality combo. Not too bad. Six, nine, probably. Shield Power. Do I need to trade with that? I don't think I do. I can just go face here. I'm gonna heal up though, just in case something weird happens. I feel like as long as we don't die on this turn, we're gonna win. So I'm gonna just use all my mana, do whatever it takes, man. Still rank 4? Man, we were deck doctoring all day. That's why. Not trying to get ladder ranks, but now we are. But we're trying to do it in a stylish way with some control paladin, man. Alright, just making some trades. He's gotta kill a 6-5 and a 5-5 to stay alive. That sounds like a lot of work. Nice mug. Dude, this mug's sweet. It's my dog. That's the... When I left to go to tournaments, she just sat at the back door and just made that face all day. I was sad and lonely. Waited for me to come back at the door. So, got a picture of it and put it on a mug. It was really cute. Paladin, crushing it, man. 2-0. All right. Let's see what we can do. Wild Pyromancer is usually a pretty solid keep. I don't mind Aldor because it just slows him down and stalls the game. Like normally in most decks you use it for hard removal. In this deck you just slow the game down to try and build into your quality turns. So I'm totally cool with just Aldor and things on 3. And we got hammers to try and help us draw that equality, man. Well, hello there. Let's just calm that down right now. If Avenge goes off, we're totally cool with it because we got this Aldor to clean up. In good position, man. Oh, Harrison Jones is great in this matchup. It's gonna help me find that equality that I need desperately. If this happens, is it worth it to Aldor? Probably not. It's probably better just to dude. I don't know. I can get behind either dude or Aldor. Both make sense in my head. I want to Aldor his 4 drop is Shredder. So I guess I can hold out for that. Shredders are annoying. Another secret. Want to Aldor off Avengers and stuff too. He's got 2 mana and he's thinking about something. Secret or dude, I guess. But a hammer, I can't Aldor in the same turn. Oh, we got the equality now. Well, let's just knock off the bubble to try and set up the equality. We need to make sure we get the Avenge practice and stuff too for the equality as well. That's some tasty Jones value.
Oh, beautiful. Yeah.
This game's going swell. We have this plus this to kill this, and then a quality to kill everything after the Avenge Redemption and whatever goes off. So I like that. I like that. And then we'll still have Aldor in our hand for the whatchamacallit. Oh god, no. That's gonna be a problem. That's gonna be a problem. Oh jeez. I like this. We're looking great. No, not so spectacular. Well, let's try and kill some things. I'm gonna go here, I guess it's fine. Probably Noble Sack Avenge, but it could be Redemption, which would be a little annoying with the spiders. Does appear to be Redemption. So, we got the old Pyro Hammer. Cleans up most things quite nicely. We gotta use our removal kinda. We can't afford to blow qualities on nothing, because he's able to draw so many cards off Divine Favor, so. Gotta be careful, man. What is this flip? Alright, we just seal the light this guy down and drop down a Belcher. Keep all of our removal ready for the big things. Hopefully the big things start coming out, because that's what we got answers for. He's either got a flood or drop some big things. Why am I awake so early? Man, I've been streaming this time every day of the week. It's not the week, every weekday. For like a long time. We've been going strong for like 3 weeks, man. That's why I'm up this early. Alright. Mysterious Challenger. Hopefully we can just take care of all of this in one go. We got this happening, and then this redeems and avenges and yada yada. And then I think we just Equality Consecrate. Well, actually, it landed on this guy, so now that gives us options. We could then simply just do this. And, what secrets are left, actually? Looks to be a Repentance and a Competitive Spirit, so whoever we play first is getting Repentanced. So that kind of sucks. So we could just do this then, I guess. I think I just want to get the Emperor proc off, even if it does get Repentanced. He might not even be able to kill it, you know? Well, it's not even Repentance. Oh, it is Repentance. Just lagged a little bit there. So then these all get up to twos, and you can go two, 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 and then he needs a weapon or something to be able to finish this guy off. So, who knows? Maybe he can kill it, maybe he can't. But either way, he's got to develop a weapon to be able to do it. He has the other True Silver, okay, okay. Both Avenge are gone, both Noble Sacrifice are gone. So what the hell are these secrets then? We got another Competitive Spirit, maybe? Another Competitive Spirit and another Redemption? What the hell? Well, that is annoying. Maybe I should have just killed everything last time. So this is the last thing that was played, so this is gonna be what gets redeemed at the end of the day. I don't know how much I want to use clearing this, but he's only got two cards, so I could just, like, Equality Consecrate. This is, his cards were secrets, so he's committed them now. So if we Equality Consecrate, then the 1-1 comes back to life, and we True Silver it. That's the play. I don't feel good about it, but I mean, I don't want to take too much more damage, and we have single target removal in our hand. I guess I'll use this True Silver so I can make the dude, kill the redeemed dude. They have Aldor for big things, so we got Wild Pyromancer to combo with our stuff. I mean, I guess it's okay. Damn. Damn, damn, damn. Alright, well, we can sword this guy and Aldor that guy. And then we're just at the mercy of Boombots for the game. We got competitive strip making all these guys huge, though. It's gonna be annoying. So I think I'd rather have the Aldor take the damage. Well, no, I can clear everything here. Okay, well, except the Dr. Boom. So let's go here first, and then Wild Pyromancer Seal Alert. Oh, it's not even competitive spirit. Okay, that's good. That's much less annoying. So I can put this into here. Oh, no, I can put this into here. There you go. There you go. Now we can clear the whole board with the Wild Pyromancer Holy Light. Alright, Seal of Light. And then make a dude. That was some good RNG. Sometimes you get a little lucky. Alright. And I'll use the Hero Power. Alright. Got the board back. Got the board back. Oh my god, that is a power turn. Really? Well, I guess that's the last big power turn. Alright, I want to play this and pass. Threaten to try and take his 5-5 here, I guess. Well, maybe I should set it up so it dies. He's gonna always make a dude there, and I need somebody to kill the dude. So I think I'd rather have my Sylvanas just not be able to die for free. If my Sylvanas dies for free and doesn't take the 5-5, we lose, so... We do this, and hopefully he's not able to find some damage here to be able to kill us. And maybe we could stabilize behind him. Alright, alright. It's not Noble Sacrifice, it has to be Competitive Spirit, man. He's running 10 secrets in his deck. 10 secrets, huh? So since we know that, we can go here and take the 1-1. Value. And then we can go just into the face. And use our True Silver to heal up for 2, so we're outside of lethal range, just barely. Both True Silvers have been used, so we should be alive here. We got some heal remaining in the deck that we can cycle to, hopefully, with this Accolade of Pain. Maybe we can make it. He's just one Consecrate, too. They usually don't run 2 Consecrates, and they usually don't run any Chargers, so... I think we could do it, man. God, Shredders are annoying. Alright, we gotta get rid of this guy. I guess I will trade in the dudes. Try and get extra value off this Accolade Fang. Okay. So we can go down to 1 health by swinging at it? I guess we do that, right? I don't know, there's so many high value cards I can get. Let's cash it in. Yeah, let's do that, and swing face. Good card. He's used 1 Coghammer and 2 True Silvers. Hopefully he doesn't run any more weapons, and hopefully he doesn't run a second copy of Consecrate. 7, 8, 9, 10. Also, hopefully we draw damage or heal. This may have been not really well thought out. Alright, we can get rid of it. We can get rid of it. It's okay. It's okay. Oof. I was like, wait a minute. This was not well thought out. Alright. Thank you, Geddon, for being able to die. Oh, there we go. Does that kill him? We got the 3. No, this isn't gonna kill him. Alright, let's get rid of this Geddon. Holy crap. Kodor to the rescue, too. That was pretty good. That was pretty good. Mm-hmm.
faith in the light. Reporting for duty.
That's pretty good. So I guess we want to do this first. Yeah. I should be able to kill him this turn, hopefully. Nope. That was not lethal. No, that had to be lethal there for us to be able to win. Never lucky. Super close. Damn, dude. First loss. Should have attacked with the 3-3. What would that accomplish, man? The Avenging fully cleared the minion. It wasn't lethal, man. Alright, let's see what we can do here. I probably don't want to keep 6 and 7 drops, but I think these are actually pretty fine to keep. Maybe not the Consecrate. I like the Pyro though. Pyro early game's pretty sweet. Got the coin, got the humility, got combos, man. Wombos all day. Alright, we got hammer time. It's hammer time. Man, I wanted the 3-3 to die. Getting kills me if it doesn't die, bro. I had to have it die. It's an unfortunate loss, but it's a casualty we had to suffer. We were at 2, man. Getting would kill us. So no, that's not a mistake, man. I did not want to die. We may be bad, but we're not suicidal. I think we're just dudin' up, man. We're just dudin'. Do-do-do-do-do. Sandstorming on him. Why don't you use golden cards? I'm not a role player. Nah, I don't have enough dust, so I don't own any of them. Alright, let's get this Belcher out there, I think. Try and set up to have this guy die and then be able to humility it or Eldor it the turn after, you know. Holy crap, another one. Alright, let's see what's behind door number one. Jiraxxus is behind door number one. It's not even that threatening, but I guess I'll turn it into a weenie. Eh, we'll be patient with it. Just gonna be able to whack dudes forever. Yeah, keeping Peacekeeper in my hand would have gave me another turn to find an answer, but I was looking just to try and extend the board as much as possible and try and be able to kill him no matter what removal spell he drew. I felt that was more likely that he draws one of his, like, 4 remaining removal spells than exactly Tyrion. So killing him was my game plan. Unfortunately, he found exactly Tyrion. lightning happens. Ooh, it's Owl Hammer. Yeah. Got some draw combos going on, so that's pretty sweet. And we don't even waste our equality combos because we have the Consecrate here to fill out the equality. So not too bad, not too bad. But I might want to put in a second Owl, man. Alright, let's clean up and draw cards. Hit this Acolyte for one. We're outdrawing the handlock. demon handlock or Reno lock or whatever kind of lock it is. It's got a hand and he's a lock. Oh man, he's making that so sick. Well, we probably can't silence Tyrion anymore, so that's the good news. Bad news is it's kind of awkward to play Tyrion this turn, unless we're just flopping her down. I guess that's not even bad. We take another 7 is the dangerous part here. Taking another 7 kind of sucks, but I think it might be worth it. I don't really want to consecrate this, do I? We don't have to worry about the roars for a little bit. But we could consecrate if we really wanted to. Doesn't seem like the worst thing in the world. I could use pyro plus humility and steel alert. Yeah, that's pretty sketchy looking. But I mean, like, what am I spending my mana on this turn is the real question. So I have like a bunch of options. None of them are very good for developing the board. Something has to develop the board the most, though. I'm guessing consecrate. we can clean up these boombots. So I guess I'll make a dude first. So the boombots hit that instead of my 3/3, hopefully, and then I'll just consecrate and then ability the guy. Well, that went all right. And I'm gonna bump here because I wanted to be damaged for the future if he silences it and tries to swing 8 at my dome. Just want to take care of business on it. If he does silence it and go face though, we're hurting. Oh, missed opportunity for him, because that would have sucked for me. And he's used the Keeper for the face now, so we can drop Tyrion. Do I die to combo if I drop Tyrion? He's got 2 he could run at my face, and then he's got... He'd have to use a 3 and a 4 into it, so he'd miss out on all of these attacks killing Tyrion, and then he'd have 12 remaining. So Tyrion seems pretty good. We also got Kodo value here. We could Seal of Light this, Kodo that. I just want to get Tyrion down now that I've seen the Keeper gone. I feel okay about it. That's how we fight back, man. Holy shit. It's got the other Keeper. Okay. Now we're facing down death and disaster, huh? Oh, there you go. We can Equality Avenging Wrath and be at 14 exactly. But then we have this. Oh, we can't do all of that in one turn. So I'd have to Equality Cons. I would have to, like, Equality something else. If I wanted to be able to get that Seal of Light out. Which I don't really want to do. So I lose my 6th guy, but... If we run to here, we could Seal of Light that, and then we could Kodo 1. That's almost clears enough, but not quite. So, if we're not playing around combo, that's the play. If I want to play around combo, which I don't think I can win if I play around combo, so I don't think I can afford to do it. So I'm going to just go with the Kodo play and hope I stay alive. This combo isn't something we beat at this point. Unless I want to, like, Equality the Wild Pyromancer than Seal of Light, but I don't think it's going to beat it. Like, our board's going to suck dick after that, is what I'm trying to say. So, I don't want to do it. I want to go all in, man. I want to go all in on saying he doesn't have combo, and hope he doesn't have combo. Equality Geddon, we still die to combo, and we don't have that strong of a board. I think this is a stronger board, and we don't die to combo. I mean, we die to combo, but we have the strongest possible board we can have on this turn. So if he's got combo, this kind of sucks, because we're dead. But if he doesn't have combo, this is the best play. I feel like if we go with the full clear, we're going to lose if he has combo in his hand anyway. Like, we're going to be 4 health out of range of combo. He's going to charge Drew to the Claw or something at her face, then combo us the turn after. Because we'd have no board to really contest it, and we'd be just stuck removing everything every turn. So I think this is, like, a better approach to getting the board back. Okay. This Shredder, man. Shredder hiding behind taunts is so annoying. What do I want to do? Okay. We can Equality, like, Avenging Wrath. That kind of sucks. I can Equality trade. Just Equality trade Geddon seems like a solid play. He's been holding some cards, so he could have BGH. I could swing. No, that's not good. I think we got a quality trade. Let's see what happens. Ancient Watcher, there you go. So, I can just develop Geddon if I want. I can just develop Willpower. I'm gonna play Geddon. I don't have any other minion to play. Get it out there. He doesn't have combo. I just want something to help contest the board. 7/5s are big. That's all I gotta say. They are big, huh? I don't know why I said that. Well, he didn't have combo earlier, so we can hope he doesn't have combo again. We're gonna need to find some of our heal. We got Lay on Hands, Heal Bot, Seal of Light, so three heal cards. We got a Wild Pyromancer that can help us try and cycle to that so we find an Acolyte. Now we use both Acolytes. Yeah, we're in a pickle for sure. I top deck combo. Damn. I mean, we knew this was happening eventually. God, buddy. Slow roll the attacks on me. Well, I mean, he didn't have it on the previous turn, so wasn't playing around it anymore. What's the point of Avenging Wrath? Not like combo clear with a quality. I don't know. Seems like a good removal cut. Alright, against Warrior. Definitely want the equality, that's the whole point of the deck. Equality clears, man. There you go, not a bad hand. Now we're looking for our Acolyte of Pains and whatnot. Now I just need Truthover and Aldovers and those sort of things, and we'll be good to go. Kodo is also really sweet in this matchup because you can just snipe off Acolyte of Pains and whatnot. Acolyte on Acolyte Love. There's a true story, that's not bad. He's Patron, he usually gets pretty Shrek'd, because Patron usually relies on your opponent not being able to clear your big board, and we can clear his big board, and then they rely on you not being able to kill Grom, and we can kill Grom, so. Usually in a pretty good spot. Yeah, giving him two cards off Acolyte, though, couldn't really help that. Tyrion's sweet in this matchup. I don't really want to Owl. I think it's more important to save Owl for bigger threats than just let him take the extra card draw. We don't care if he floods the board, we got answers for days. And by for days, I mean one time. What's the win condition of this deck? Tyrion, man. Outlast and Tyrion. You don't really need too big of a win condition in the current Hearthstone meta because nobody plays control decks because they suck. So you just need to stay alive if you're a late curve deck. This guy use Viewbots like Masan? If I did use Viewbots, then I have the angriest Viewbots ever because they talk so much shit. Like, holy god. I would really need to talk to my ViewBot programmer and tell him, Jesus, could you make it less realistic and get some ViewBots that actually say nice things? But, alas, it's not the case. I'm gonna hold back the Keeper of Alderman here to use it as an answer, because we are the control deck. We're just reacting to him and being patient. Alright. We are going to be going to Fatigue, so we're going to look at trying to draw fewer cards than our opponent, so we're crushing it on that. So, I'm probably just never going to play this hammer, right? Well, I can afford to draw one card. I guess that's what they all say. 3, 6, 9. Alright, I'm going to draw one card. Just one. I mean, I could just use the hammer. Well, no, I want to be playing Tyrion next turn. Alright, I'm going to just draw... Well, if I'm playing Tyrion next turn, maybe I lose the weapon. That makes sense to me. It's just like, what am I doing with my mana this turn then, is the real question. So, I'm gonna just cycle it. there'll be something to swing at next turn, I'm sure. 3, 6, 9. Let me just make a dude and hit him in the face, little kid. Hopefully he doesn't play something super big so I can safely just Tyrion on him. He's gotta play a card though, he's at 10. Ben Jarman? Fantastic. Well, we got nothing to swing at, which kinda sucks. So we would lose this Truce of Recharge if he kills the Tyrion. Guess we're okay with it. He's drawing more cards. Look at you go. Look at you go. I like that. I like that. Oh no, no, no execute. He's probably got one execute in his hand, he's saving it for Ysera. You don't run Ysera though. You don't want to play this card ever, that's the ultimate rule here. The ultimate rule. 3, 6, 9, 10. Gotta play something. So we got options. I'm thinking we're just playing Geddon and hoping he doesn't have his BGH yet. Because that's the card in his deck that kills Geddon efficiently. No other cards kill it efficiently. So if he's got to waste hard removal on it, I'm happy about it. So I just throw it out there. We have other quality combos in our hand. I don't want to Avenging Wrath his face. I have to play a card so I don't overdraw. I don't want to get Acolyte of Pains out there because this game's going to fatigue and he's pyroblasting himself in the face right now, which is awesome. Look at these card counts. I love it. So, we're just going to try not to do that. Alright, that's our only BGH target and it was not killed by BGH, so he's going to have a dead BGH in his hand for the rest of the game. So that's going to be terrific. Oh god, he runs Elise. He's going to turn his Control Warrior legendaries into other legendaries. Yeah. Oh, we're gonna whack that hit. And I guess we're heal body. I don't wanna play any of these other cards. These are all answers to things. Gotta wait for the right time.